Look at that body bend. How does it do that? Researchers uncover the mechanisms behind the thresher shark's vertebrae that allow for their body bending acrobatics when hunting prey. Check it out on this episode of NSF Science Now. Indiana Jones isn't the only one who has mastered the art of the whip. Meet the Thresher Shark. Its machete-like tail is used to slap and stun prey, allowing it to swallow multiple fish in one fell swoop. Its beauty is captivating for divers lucky to spot one.
Well, it's thrilling to see such large creatures cruising around. From all we know about their behavior, they're certainly not going to be aggressive to divers or to anything that's remotely their size. They're just so graceful and have such a beautiful shape, obviously evolved to that exact environment, so that they're just there's something you can sit and watch for hours if you could.
But this isn't any ordinary shark. Its tail sets it apart, measuring almost half the length of its own body, making threshers very large in the world of sharks. It's also a quick, strategic, and formidable hunter.
So the thresher shark tail whip can be really effective if the thresher sharks are working together and create a nice tight ball of fish. If you've got a nice dense group of fish, your chances of being able to hit or stun one are going to increase compared to if you have a bunch of fish that are really spread farther apart.
The thresher shark's tail makes it a unique thing of beauty.
So they're very sleek, very streamlined. They swim in currents against the current without seemingly the slightest effort. They're just graceful.
While its tail whipping attack is well known, new NSF-supported research from Florida Atlantic University wanted to understand the mechanisms behind the thresher shark's vertebrae that allow this body-bending acrobatics. Using micro-CT scanning, the team imaged the internal architecture of each vertebrae and the mineral structures found in the calcified cartilage.
What we did in this lab was called micro-CT scanning. If you've ever had a CAT scan at the doctor, it's the same technology. It's three-dimensional x-rays. So we took our vertebral samples and we put them in a canister. We loaded that canister into our micro CT scanner, where we took thousands of x-ray images of the vertebrae. Then we used a computer where we can digitally stitch them together and dissect through the specimen without physically cutting into it. Then using the computer, we're able to take those images and run our analyses on the vertebrae.
These images help the team understand exactly how the shark's catapult system works.
You can see here on the left, we have a vertebrae from the anterior body, which is the front of the shark closer to the head. And on the right here, we have vertebrae from the back of the body or the posterior body closer to the tail. After counting these mineralized structures, what we found were the vertebrae in the front of the body had more of these branching nodes compared to the vertebrae on the back of the body. What we then hypothesized was that these nodes help stabilize the structure of the vertebrae and help create that stable platform for our tail whipping shark catapult to work.
This research not only fostered partnerships with agencies like NSF and NOAA, but the team also worked closely with FAU High School, helping to foster the next generation of scientists.
The CT scanner that we most often use is housed at FAU High School, so we're able to go do work at the high school associated with the university. That helps us interact and train even younger scientists, our K-12 future scientists, and we're able to really work within the College of Education, federal agencies, to train students of all ages.